Hey Tech Advisor fans, Adam here to talk about yet another gaming phone, the Lenovo Legion Phone Duel. Now I'm going to start off by saying that the Lenovo Legion Phone Duel here is only going to be released in China and other select markets. Unfortunately, it is not coming to the US, and that really bums me out because this is a pretty interesting gaming phone, and yes, I still like gaming phones. So what I want to do in this video is check out the packaging, get into the experience, show off some of the unique features it has, and then compare it to the Asus ROG Phone 3 that I looked at a couple weeks ago. So let's dive in. All right, so right here I have the box, and it's got a nice colorful gleam on the top. That's pretty fun. Nothing super special around the rest of it. Just a nice clean design like the rest of Lenovo's Legion lineup. We're gonna put that over there. And inside, got that nice, cool sheen to it. Kind of wraps around all the edges, as you can see. And it has a cool little trick. When you flip it open and reveal the Legion logo here, you flip it open and then open up the arms and bam. Now you know you're playing with power. There it is. There's the phone. I'm actually going to set this aside real quick so we can get to what's in the rest of the box. So a little tray up here, then a little message for us. Stylish on the outside, savage on the inside. So I'm assuming, okay, SIM tray tool. We have a, of course, the prerequisite USB-C to 3.5 millimeter headphone jack. I gotta say, I'm really bummed that this phone does not have a headphone jack. It really bums me out that gaming phones do not have headphone jacks. I'm so a little bummed by that, but whatever. Quick start guide, whatever, we don't read manuals. And there is an included case. So let's give this a little bit of a bend. I'm gonna tell you, this is pretty flimsy. I feel like I could easily break it. So most of the protection is gonna be on the hard corners here. So yeah, we'll try that on. Got a little bit of a texture here too, so that's nice. Put that aside. And inside, we actually have a charging brick. This is a very special charging brick. Oh look, it says engineering sample, so hopefully it doesn't explode on me. Cool design. This thing's hefty. Oh, and it's got two ports. That also supports the reason why there are two USB plugs, because one of the cool features of this phone is that you actually get to plug in both at the same time. The phone itself has two USB-C ports, and you get 90 watt charging. That's just insane. Hopefully it will not burn down my house. Let's put all this back. Let's get back to the phone. All right, so back to the phone itself. I'm just gonna unwrap it here and slide it out. So there it is. So this comes in two colors. The one I have right here is Vengeance Red, but there's also a Blazing Blue. And it's got this interesting texture on the side here. I'm gonna hold it up to the microphone, and I think you're gonna be able to hear my fingernail run across it. It's kind of a cool texture. I haven't really seen that on a phone. Adds a little bit of a grip when you're using it horizontally. And of course you can see the other unique feature, the actual cameras are almost straight in the middle of this phone so that it's out of the way of your hand when you're holding it for gaming. And then this little Lenovo Y symbol for on their Legion line is RGB, so it lights up because, of course, you got to game better with the RGB. This is a flash. Around the front, we will notice that there is no selfie camera. So what happens is that this module slides up to reveal the selfie camera. We'll show that in a second once I get into the software. But interesting enough, when you kind of get real close to it, the power button is actually on this pop-up camera. So the power button slides up with the camera. At first, I thought maybe it helped eject the camera, but no, that's the actual power button for the phone, so that's pretty cool. And then yeah, on the top here you can see the where the shoulder buttons or triggers or whatever the hell they call them has nice indications by these little Lenovo Y symbols. So when you're holding in your hand, helps you know where you're supposed to put your fingers to activate. So that's pretty cool. Along the top, it's got this nice stylish red. It's concave, so a little bit of a dip. On this side, we got some nice Lenovo branding. There we go. And then here's one of two USB-C chargers. This is along the bottom side. Got a volume rocker right there. On the bottom, we have the other USB-C port, and then the SIM card tray. So let me pop this out. The SIM card tray actually has room for two SIM cards. This does not support a micro SD card expansion, so it is just SIM only. One other thing to note, and it might be really hard to see, but you can see there's a very thin layer of film already applied to the front panel here, probably for protection, built in to the screen here. It doesn't bug me. Hopefully it doesn't ruin the phone if you peel it up, but then you can also see the nice red branding around the grills here, and of course dual front-firing speakers. Yes, thumbs up for that. Okay, so what I want to do next now is power this on, maybe give it a little bit of a charge, and come back and see what the experience is like using this phone. All right, the phone is all set up. I'm here at the home screen. The first thing I'll note is that the battery was dead. So I plugged in the 90 watt charging, which included both cables, and it felt really silly, but I will tell you what, it went from 0% battery to 25% in 5 minutes. That is pretty damn quick. I expected to pick up the phone and burn my hand, but actually the phone wasn't that warm, so good on Lenovo for not catching anything on fire. So that's a pretty cool feature. But yeah, once we're in the home screen, the first place I want to take you is into the settings, because along with the general settings that they have, you know, just in normal Android, there are a couple things to note. The first one is the Legion Wiki. I'm gonna try to get it right there. And as you can see, there's another thing I'm gonna show you in a second, Legion Realm, which is kind of where all of the game management software is. And they have some interesting gaming features that you can configure here. Lenovo Assistant is their version of sliding down to have the quick functionality when you're in a game. I'll show that off in a minute. Back recording, which is kind of like a feature, if you slide your finger across the top shoulder here, you can get some of the gameplay that you just did. Depending on the configuration, it'll go up to, I think, 15 seconds at 720p. Y triggers, that's what they're calling them. So these mimic the shoulder buttons, just like the ROG phone has. Now the Y button functionality is a little more limited compared to the ROG, but that's fine because I'm still mostly using them for a single button press, and that doesn't bug me at all. Another fun one is the selfie for stream. It's why they included the selfie cam as a pop-up here in the middle, so that you could overlay your own video on the gameplay. I'll show you that in a second because it's actually pretty fun. And then peripherals, you can plug in Bluetooth mouse and keyboard. If you want to, you can plug this into an external monitor. You can do all that as well. I'm not going to do that here, but just know that it is supported. So the dual turbo charging is what I was alluding to, the 90 watts, and it uses a special turbocharge protocol that is pretty awesome. And one of my favorite features on a gaming phone is dual front-facing speakers. It's a nice little demo here. You're probably not going to be able to hear it too much on this video, but there is a lot of separation between the two speakers, and it sounds really nice. I like it. There is another interesting feature where it uses the vibration motors across the whole length of the device to simulate a left and right stereo panning. So when you're holding it, you can't feel it right now, but this demo is showing this car starting off on the left side and kind of rumbling across to the right side. It's a nice little effect. There's not a lot of separation between the two, but it's interesting. And then Xcast, this will allow you to go to an extended display. Next up, let's check out Legion Realm. You can get to the settings in here in the settings menu or in the app itself. I'm just going to step through some of the stuff in the settings menu here. They have Legion Assistant. Like I said, it's the pull-down feature to get to some of your quick actions. You can change the ordering of the shortcuts. You can turn on performance mode, clear the cache. Network boost, all of this stuff is available in the actual Legion Assistant that I'll be showing off in a second. Realm settings, the only toggle here is to give you some game recommendations. I already have loaded up some games, so it's not going to show me too many recommendations. But you can also trigger the actual app by long pressing both of the Y triggers. That'll actually launch the app. Back recording, like I said, if you want to roll back some of your capture footage. Here are the settings that you have. Even though this screen does support up to 144 hertz refresh rate, you can only really capture in 30 frames, and it defaults to 720p. So same thing here for the settings. Defaults to 15 seconds, but I'm sorry, it can go up to 30 seconds depending on the performance. And then the soundtrack, this is the recording in the video. In the rollback video, do you want from the game or do you want from the microphones on the actual phone itself? The last thing to look at is the Y triggers. You can kind of customize how far each trigger is pressed in order to get the sensitivity right. I'm just gonna leave it at its default, discard the changes, and then how strong you want the actual presses to be. So. Let's go ahead and go back here. There's a couple other things. Lighting effects. This affects the RGB logo on the back. And I will say they change between gaming, income calls, notification, and charging. But if you want to change just the static effect, it's that Legion right there. I do have the logo set to turn on when the screen is on. Turn around the side and you can see, in fact, that it is pulsing red. So within each scenario, you can change the different lighting effects depending on what the scenario is. Charging will show you red, yellow, or green depending on the charging level. Game Stereo Enhance, it's the Hyper Audio. I'm assuming they're just doing a little bit more of the spatialization and trying to amp the signal a little bit more. You can change the display refresh rate. This supports 60, 90, and 144, but you can force it to say, you know what, maybe in the actual day-to-day usage, I just want to use 60 to save on battery, but we can switch to 144 hertz when we are in a game. So that's what that is. And then the semi-real vibration, this is showing that vibration demo of the left to right separation for the vibration, and these are the games that are supported. In it, I already have these two games installed, so I'll try those out at a later date and see how they go. So I can get into the Legion Realm by hitting this button here or holding long pressing the Y triggers. And there you go. Here is Legion Realm. At the top, it'll show the CPU and GPU utilization as you're kind of moving around the display. It says that we're in 144 hertz mode with the ultra stereo and pyramid cooling, which is their marketing way to talk about the active cooling that happens inside the phone. So this is just a list of all the games that I have already downloaded onto the phone. If you hit the plus symbol, you can manually add games that didn't appear in here or search all of your apps. If I wanted this app to think that Facebook was a game, I could indeed add it. I don't, so I'm not going to do that. And then this button right here, this little cube, will take you into the same settings that we saw in the Android settings. So that's where you do that. I'm going to launch a game. One of my favorite games I like to play on these gaming phones is Call of Duty Mobile. Because I feel like I absolutely dominate when I have the shoulder triggers available. So now that we're in the game, I'm going to slide down to reveal the quick settings here. Kind of shows you your ping level for the networking features that you have. Right now I am on Wi-Fi, so that's why it's connected. if I was on 4G, this one would be showing me the statistics here. I can change the brightness of the display with this toggle right here. You can see that the game is actually running at 30 hertz or 30 frames per second, even though I have the display set to 144. Some games support it, some games don't. It's a game by game basis. And it'll show you the temperature of the phone itself. It has this kind of overdrive mode where it'll ramp up the CPU and GPU utilization. You hit this button, it gives a little bit of a vibration, and you can see these lines kind of start to shimmer with rampage, just pure rage. Yeah, it's pretty funny, I like it. So we're gonna turn that off for now. We can adjust the volume of the phone here. I'm gonna turn it down a little bit because this game has some audio. And then here are the quick settings that you can get to. There's enabling the back recording. You can set up the controls for the multi-touch input. The stream mode is the one thing that I was excited to show everyone, because if you watch the sliding indication up here, boom, there's the selfie camera, and you can see me as a little video overlay here. So I'm gonna move this around the screen wherever I want to kind of overlay on my gameplay footage. This is either in the recorded video or obviously if you were to stream out live. But I actually think that's kind of a fun feature, and especially if you're gaming like this horizontally, then your fingers don't get in the way of whatever selfie cam is usually somewhere up here. So that's pretty cool. I dig it. And then you also have a couple controls here. Like changing some overlay features if I wanted to wear, you know, a cool hat and shades. Yeah, I'm gonna go with that. A little hard to see, but yeah, I'm not gonna do that. You can change. Wow. Okay, it is trying to just focus on me and block out distracting background elements, but the camera is fooling it a little bit. We're gonna turn that off because that's annoying. And then this is kind of like a little bit of a dimming mode, so you see just a little bit of me, but not too much. And then you can lock it in place so you don't accidentally move the video around. Lock it in place, then I can't move it. Okay, let me turn that off for now because it's a little distracting. Go back in here. Screen shoot, that's obviously to capture the screen. Screen capture is saved to gallery. Let's swipe over here. Vibration, you could turn it on or off. You can clean the RAM to kind of, you know, make sure that your game is running optimally. I don't want to receive phone calls while I'm gaming, nor do I want messages to pop up, so those are both checked. No gesture, meaning using the back gesture controls or the swipe up to go home. I actually want to keep that disabled to be able to get back and forth easily, because I'm not in the middle of a tournament right now. Lighting, you can turn on and off, and then there's quick options to go to WhatsApp and Line, neither of which I use, so I'm not gonna go in there. So let's start a little game of a team deathmatch and see what it's like to use the Y triggers. All right, so I'm in a match of Call of Duty here. I have the fire button and the reload button that maybe I wanna have quick access to. So the left Y trigger, actually let's do aim down the sights with the left and then fire with the right. You just hover them over there, make sure it's turned on, and close it so that when I'm running around, it's indeed look down the sights, and there is the trigger. Oh boy, and I died. That's great. So maybe it doesn't necessarily make you a better player, but potentially if you're a good player, maybe it helps give you the edge. Oh, there we go. I'll take that. Do a little bit of reloading. Whoop. And I died again. Nice. All right. Victory. I'll take it. Oh, look at that. I got the final kill with my pistol. I accidentally switched to it. All right. So, you know, it's not going to make me the best player in the world, but I like it. I feel like it does give me a good advantage, so I'm a big fan. But yeah, now let's take the Lenovo Legion Phone Duel and put it up against the Asus ROG Phone 3. Oh, look at that. I got second place. Cool. Thank you, Lenovo. Okay, so I got both phones here, and as you can see, the ROG Phone 3 is kitted out with not only the lightning case, but also the Aero Active Cooling 3, whatever it's called. So I do want to try out this case for the Lenovo. Huh. Not quite sure which side is up, which side is down. Maybe it doesn't matter. Let's do that. Okay. It doesn't look too bad. Still gives you a little bit of a grip. Not a huge fan of it, but it at least offers a little bit of protection, so there you go. I'm gonna take it off. I'm also going to take off the extra features on this Asus ROG here, so we can kinda check out the phone itself. So here's how they look side by side. Both pretty stylish. I would say obviously the ROG phone is a little more muted, but it's kind of scaled back over the years from the original release. So it's not bad, but size-wise, I mean, God, they're actually pretty damn close. It's kind of hard to tell here, but yeah, I would say maybe the Lenovo Legion is a tad wider. Maybe a tad shorter, and then when I put them down, I'm gonna say that the Lenovo Legion is a tad thicker as well. So with the screens on, you can see there's actually just a little bit more bezel around the edge on the ROG phone. It doesn't bug me. It's not a huge difference, but it is just a little thinner on the Lenovo Legion, even though they both have plenty of space for their speaker systems. All in all, the Lenovo Legion Phone Duel is actually cheaper than the ROG phone by quite a stretch, but I still think it's a damn good option if you're looking for a gaming phone. Definitely one that screams gamer, that's for damn sure. But yeah, I'm excited to try it out some more, and even though it is not coming to the US, I feel lucky that I get to try it out, because this is a pretty damn cool phone. I'm happy with Lenovo's first take at the gaming phone market. So be sure to subscribe and come back to Tech Advisor for more awesome smartphone videos. We will see you later.